Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. So our topic today is about system of inequalities. So last time system of equations, but this time system of inequalities. So this one should be 3.2. This is 3.2. Okay, so objective here, so you will be able to draw the graph, then find the correct region for solving the system of inequalities. Yes, so ni untuk lorik-lorik lah. Kalau siapa yang pernah belajar dulu masa tingkatan 5, saya rasa MacModern. Okay, so MacModern lah sini. Bukan Admet. Okay, so tak kisahlah mana satu. Okay, so masa tingkatan 5, so korang akan ada belajar. So draw the graph. Okay, so ni this one example for two equation ni. So ada dua equation. Okay, so draw the graph and then kita lorikkan bahagian yang mana yang memenuhi sistem tersebut, system of inequalities. Okay, so tu kau ingat. So kita draw graph tu, dia ada yang solid line, yang dotted line. Ni kalau korang nampak ni merah ni dotted line. Okay, so dash. Okay. So ni saya gunakan Desmos lah. So macam nak guna Desmos, just key in je function dia. Function apa? Okay. So nanti saya tunjuk. Tapi kat sini Desmos ni untuk bahagian lorik ni dia limit untuk dua function lah. Tapi dalam soalan tu kadang dia bagi tiga function, empat function. So yang tu tak boleh nak lorik lah. So for this Desmos, you can use to check whether your graph is correct or not. Okay. So boleh check. Dan nanti saya tunjuk macam mana nak check. Okay, so this one. Okay, so step dia. So solving systems of inequalities. Okay, so first when you have the question. Okay, so biasa question akan bagi macam ni lah. Okay, so this one system of inequalities. Okay, so one equation, second equation, and we have this constant. Okay, so kita ada tiga. Satu, dua, tiga. Tapi dalam Desmos tadi ada boleh dua je. So yang ketiga ni kita tak boleh nak letak lah macam mana. Okay. Okay, so therefore for solving the system of inequalities, so first step, choose either x or y as a subject and it is must be positive. For example this one. Okay, so this one y as the subject. Okay, so ni y dah ada kat depan. Okay, so maksud subject tu, saya kata maksud subject tu maksud dia dekat depan ni. Depan ni mesti y ataupun x. Okay, so kalau dalam example ni dah, dia dah buat siap-siap lah y, y. Okay, so subject dia y. So yang bawah ni kita tak boleh nak tulis subjek dia lah x ataupun y, sebab dia ada dua inequalities. Okay, so ada dua bahagian, this one and y. Okay, so this one biar je. Okay, so this one condition for x, which is from negative 2 until 2. Okay, and then bila kita dah pilih subjek dia, and then we draw the graph. Okay, so in drawing the graph, okay, so first you need to recognize whether the graph is straight line, quadratic, circle or parabola or else. And then after recognize the type of the graph, okay, so you can start by finding the x-intercept and y-intercept. Okay, so please remember x-intercept, the coordinate of y is 0. Okay, so ni pintas paksi x. Okay, so ni paksi x, pintas paksi x. So maksudnya dia potong pada paksi x dekat sini. Okay, so bila dia potong paksi x, kalau kita tengok paksi x ni kat sini mesti ada nilai x. Nilai y dia kosong. Okay, so kalau tak hafal pun boleh faham daripada graf. Okay, so daripada graf kena faham. Okay, so kalau dia potong pada sini, ha, ni dia potong paksi x ni. So dekat sini x dia ada nilai. Okay, so x ada nilai, but value for y is 0. Okay, so for the y intercept pun sama, pintasan paksi y. So kalau dia potong paksi y macam ni, so this one, nilai untuk y kita ada. Sebab y sini kosong, naik atas y makin ada kan, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So nilai y mesti ada, tapi nilai x dia kosong. Okay, so at y intercept, the coordinate of x is 0. And then after finding the x intercept and y intercept, okay, you draw the graph. Okay, so in drawing the graph, the line should be follow this one. Okay, So if the inequalities we have equal sign, okay, so kalau inequalities tu ada simbol sama dengan, so the line is solid line. If there is no equal sign, so the line is dotted line. Okay, so siapa yang mahir lukis graf, ha, tak payah nak cari x intercept, y intercept tu pun tak apalah, tak kisahlah, ikut kemahiran masing-masing. Ada orang yang dia dah hafal x square macam mana graf dia, pasti x, y sama dengan x macam mana graf dia. Okay, so tu pun tak boleh je. Okay, so tapi jangan confident sangat, ha, nanti check dekat Desmos betul ke tak betul. Okay, and then after draw the graph, so we shade the correct region. Okay, so to shade the correct region, so we refer to this one. Okay, so ni saya konsep ni saya pakai ni paksi x ni, so this one paksi y. Sebelah kiri ni kecil, kalau ke kanan dia besar. Paksi y pun sama, ke atas besar, ke bawah kecil. Okay, so therefore for x, if x as the subject, so we shade the left side. If we have okay, so we shade the left side of the graph if we have the sign less than. Okay, so kalau kita ada less than, symbol less than, so kita akan lorek sebelah kiri. Okay, sebab kecil, lagi kecil, so kecil sebelah kiri. So nanti kita ada graph. Okay, contoh this one is the graph. Okay, so kita akan lorek sebelah kiri. Okay, so if we have greater than, so we shade the right side of the graph. And for the y as the subject, okay, so if we have the less than sign, okay, so we shade the below of the graph. And if we have the greater sign, so we shade the above graph. Okay, so sebelah atas, atas graph. Okay, so bukan atas paksi y ataupun kiri paksi x, bukan atas paksi y ataupun bawah pak. Okay, so bukan atas paksi x ataupun paksi x. Okay, so kita tarik bawah graph ataupun atas graph. Ni pun sama. Okay, sebelah kiri sebelah kanan ni, so okay, dia bukan kiri paksi y ataupun kanan paksi y, tapi dia kiri graph dan kanan graph. Okay, okay, so nak lagi faham, kita pergi ke example. Okay, example this one. Okay, so we have this three inequalities. Okay, so kita ada tiga. Okay, so first choose y or x as a subject. So this one already y. Okay, so tak payah nak pindah-pindah. So y already subject. And then draw the graph. Okay, so to draw the graph, so recognize first, this is what type of the graph. Okay, so this one x square over, okay, so x square minus 9. So x square minus 1, this one is quadratic. Okay, so untuk lukis graf ni kita letak simbol sama dengan lah, tak payah letak less than ataupun greater than. And then second, we have y equal to 3 over 2x and minus 3. So this one x is power of 1. Okay, so this one is linear graph or straight line. Okay, so straight line graph. Okay, so next we find the intercept. Okay, so for the first equation, y equal to x square minus 9. Okay, so first one, this one y 0, so we find the x intercept. Okay, so when y equal to 0, okay, so buat calculation sikit. So y equal to 0, so substitute here 0, so 0 is equal to x square minus 9. Okay, so therefore this one is quadratic. So quadratic korang kena faktorkan. Okay, so faktorkan, you will have x minus 3 and x plus 3, which is equal to 0. Okay, so from this one we have x equal to positive or negative 3. And then for y intercept, okay, so for the y intercept, coordinate of x is 0. So substitute x equal to 0, so y equal to 0 square minus 9. So we have y equal to negative 9. And then for the second equation, okay, so we have y equal to 3 over 2x minus 3. Okay, so first one for x intercept, so when y equal to 0, so do calculation. Okay, so y equal to 0, 0 is equal to 3 over 2x minus 3. Okay, so pindah, so we will have 3 over 2x equal to 3. Okay, so x is equal to 3 divided by 3 over 2. So we have 2 actually. Okay? And then for y-intercept, coordinate of x is 0. So substitute here 0. So y is equal to negative 3. And then draw the graph. Okay, so draw the graph. Oops. Okay, so for x equal to positive negative 3, okay, so put here negative 3, and here is positive 3. Okay, so y is 0, so we have here. And then when x equal to 0, y equal to negative 9. Okay, so pasti y saya singgit ni. Okay, so y equal to negative 9. So put here negative 9. Okay. So you know that this is the quadratic graph. So draw the quadratic. And here is positive. Okay, so a is positive. So the graph is smiling graph. Okay, and then this one. Okay, so this one is the straight line graph. Okay, so straight line graph when x equal to 2, so here 3 and here is 2. Okay, so 2, y is 0, so here. And then when y equal to 0, and when x equal to 0, y is negative 3. So 0, negative 3, put here. Okay, so we have this thing. Okay. And then shade the region. Oh, one more. Okay, so one more I forget. So saya terlupa. Okay, so for the quadratic actually is dotted because there is no equal sign. Okay, so for the straight line. Okay, so for the straight line is solid line. Alamak, tapi saya dah lukis. Alah, tak boleh padam lah. Saya tak boleh padam. Okay, so sorry. Saya tak boleh nak padam. Boleh kot. Okay, so dotted line. Okay, ha. Okay, so after that, what you need to do? Okay, so x is from 2 until negative 2. So here is 2. X. Okay, so this one here is 2. Okay, so here is 2. And here is negative 2. Okay, so negative 2 here, I think, at this one. Okay, so you can check at this most. Okay, so that's most. So minus by 9. And here another one, 3 over 2x. Okay, so 3 over 2x. Mana over ni? Okay, so this one over, we use divide. So 3 over 2 minus by 3. Okay, so this one. Okay. Okay, so oh, tak sampai. Okay, so this one negative 2. So negative 2 dia dekat sini. Okay. Okay, so nampak tak? Okay, so saya zoom sikit. Okay, so this one negative 2. Okay, so here negative 2. Okay, so negative 2 is here. sudah tak sampai dekat persilangan ni, sudah belakang lagi sikit, okey. Ha. Okay, so yang lorik ni daripada yang ni, okey, padam tu, okey. Ha. So maksudnya saya punya graf tadi betul. Ha. So itu cara nak check graf itu betul ke tak. Okey, so guna Desmos. Okay, so and then, okay, so saya letak balik tadi negatif tu dekat sini kan, saya letak sini negatif tu. Okay, so since x is from negative 2 and 2, okay, so negative 2 and 2, so this one we draw a line, kita buat line, straight line, okay. And then check the shaded region. Okay, so for the first one greater than. Okay, so for the quadratic graph, okay, so quadratic graph ni, so greater than dia sebelah atas. So this is the graph. Okay, so we lorik above the graph, atas dia. Okay. And since x is from between negative 2 and 2, so kita lorik tak lebih daripada border ni lah, garisan ni, okay. And then for the second graph, y less than or equal to 3 over 2x minus 3. Okay, so this line. Okay, so straight line ni. So less than, meaning that kita lorik yang bawah. Okay, so bawah graf ni. Okay. Okay, so and then kita lorikkan. So kawasan melorik dia adalah yang sini. Okay. So another example. So this one nampak dia bagi 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so first choose y or x as a subject for all the inequalities. Okay, so for the first one, okay, so pilihlah. Okay, so biasanya y lah sebagai subject. Mostly kita guna y lah. Okay, so but here is negative y. Okay, so to be positive, this negative y we bring to the right. Okay, so from here we have x greater than or equal to 2 plus y. And then 2 kita pindah pergi ke sini. So we have x minus by 2 greater than or equal to y. And then terbalikkan, kita akan ada y less than or equal to x minus by 2. First equation. Okay, so and then one more. Okay, so check dulu jenis graf ni. Okay, so check the type of this graph. So this one is the straight line. Then second. Okay, so second one also same. Okay, so I choose y. So y greater than, so the rest this one bring to the right. So we have 1 over 3x minus by 1. Okay, so this one also the highest power of x is 1. So this one is the straight line graph. Okay, so this one x less than or equal to 2 and y is less than or equal to 0. Okay, so for the first one, okay, so for this one actually we will draw a graph which is x equal to 4 and this one is y equal to 0. Okay, so draw the graph. So for the first graph, which is y equal to x minus 2, and for the second graph, which is y is equal to negative 1 over 3x minus 1. Okay, so find the x-intercept. Okay, so for the x-intercept, the value of y is 0. Okay, so substitute here 0, calculate, so we have x equal to 2. And then for y-intercept, okay, so substitute x 0, so we have y equal to negative 2. And for this one, okay, so y equal to 0, so we will have 0 equal to negative 1 over 3x minus 1. So 1 over 3x is equal to negative 1. So x is equal to negative 3. So we have here negative 3. And when x equal to 0, x equal to 0, so substitute here 0. So y is equal to negative 1. Okay. And then draw the graph. Okay, so for x2 put here too, and another one tadi. Okay, so when x2 y is 0. Okay, so x2 y 0, y 0 here, so x2 here. Okay, and then when y equal to 0, when 0 y equal to negative 2, so here put negative 2. Okay, so when x 0 y negative 2, so here. Okay, so for the first graph, it is a straight line. So buat garisan lurus. Okay. And then for the second graph, straight line. So when x equal to negative 3, so put negative 3 here, negative 2, and here is negative 3. Okay, so x equal to negative 3, y is 0, so y 0, so here. And then when x equal to 0, y equal to negative 1, so here negative 2, so put here negative 1. Okay, so we have the graph like this. Yep. Okay, so this one. Okay, so to find the region, so before that, so it is a straight line and actually it is a dotted line. Okay, so saya lupa. Okay, so there is no equal sign. Okay, so should be dotted line. Okay, so dotted line. And then for x equal to 4, so x is equal to 4, so here 2 and here is 4. Okay, so draw a straight line. And then another one, y equal to 0, so y equal to 0 here lah. Okay, so pasti x ni. Okay, so this one y equal to 0. Okay, so and then shade the region. Okay, so lorikkan kawasan dia. Okay, so for the first one, okay, so refer to this one. For the first one, so y less than or equal to x minus 2. Graf dia yang mana? Yang ni. Okay, so less than, kita akan lorik sebelah bawah. Okay. And then second one, y greater than negative 1 over 3 x minus 1. Okay, so graph for the second one is this one, the dotted line. Tapi dia kata greater than. So greater than kita lorik belah atas. Okay. So sebelah sini tak payah tengok lah, sebab yang first lorik dah belah bawah ni. So yang ada anak panah ke bawah ni yang kita akan fokus. So yang sebelah sini dah tak payah lah. Okay, so sebelah sini ni dah tak payah. Okay. And then third one, x less than 4. Okay, so x less than or equal to 4 dia sebelah kiri. Okay, so sebelah kiri sebelah sini lah. Okay, so sini bawah ni tak payah. So second one, atas yang ni. Okay, so maksudnya dia punya kawasan belorik dekat sini. Ha. Okay, so yang bawah ni dah tak payah tengok. Okay. Tapi dia kata x less than or equal to 4. So dia sebelah kiri. So bila sebelah kiri, sebelah sini lah. Okay, so kita dah tengok dekat bahagian dalam ni. Okay. So yang segi tiga ni. Okay. So sebelum tu saya clearkan dulu. Okay, so tadi saya dah nampak dah yang segi tiga kan. Tapi segitiga kita ada dua bahagian lah. This one or this one. Okay, so to check whether below one or upper one, so we go to the fourth one. Y less than or equal to 0. So this one y equal to 0. Straight line yang ni. Okay, so this one y equal to 0. So less than. So dia sebelah bawah. So kita dapat yang ni lah, kawasan beluri ni, shader region. Okay, okay, so example for the question. Okay, so sketch the system of inequalities given below and shade the visible region. Okay, so soalan macam sama lah sebelum tadi. Okay, so first we choose the subject X or Y. Okay, so this one already Y. Okay, so first one already Y, second one already Y, only third one. So this one choose the subject. So I choose here Y. So I have Y less than or equal to 6 minus 2 X. Okay, okay, so and then recognize the type of the graph. Okay, so this one there is a power of 2, so therefore this one is quadratic graph. Okay, so this one X minus 1. Okay, so this one straight line graph. And this one also 6 minus 2 X. So this one also straight line graph. Sama. Okay, so and then draw the graph. Okay, so for the first one, okay, so y is equal to x minus 2 square minus 1. Okay, so x, y, find x intercept and y intercept. Okay, so for x intercept, coordinate of y is 0. Okay, so for y intercept, coordinate of x is 0. Okay. Okay, so for when y equal to 0, so substitute, so we have 0 equal to x minus 2 square minus 1. Okay, so x minus 2 square is equal to 1. So x minus 2 is equal to square root of 1. So square root of 1, we have positive negative 1. Okay, so we have x equal to positive negative 1 minus by 2, plus by 2. Okay, so we have to answer lah. Okay, so when y equal to 0, so x is equal to positive 1 plus 2, which is 3, and another one, negative 1 plus 2, which is 1. Okay, so 3 or 1. Okay, so dia ada dua nilai. And then when x equal to 0, so we will have y equal to 0 minus 2 power of 2 minus 1, so which is 4 minus 1. So the answer is 3. Okay. And then for the second one, y is equal to x minus 1. So draw the graph. X, y. Okay, so here x intercept y 0, y intercept x 0. Okay, so and then substitute. Okay, so when y equal to 0, so 0 equal to x minus 1, so we have the value of x, which is 1. And then when x equal to 0, so substitute here 0, so y equal to 0 minus 1, so y is negative 1. Then for the last one, which is y equal to 6 minus 2 x. Okay, so x, y, so 0, 0. Okay, so for x intercept, when y equal to 0, so we have 0 equal to 6 minus 2x. Okay, so kira. Okay, so we have x equal to 6 divided by 2, which is 3. And then when x equal to 0, we have y equal to 6. Okay, so after that, alamak, hilang lah pula. Okay, kejap. Okay, so saya dah salin semua ni. Okay, draw the graph. Okay, so for the first one, this one, quadratic graph. So when y equal to 0, so x is equal to 3 and 1. So put here 1 and put here 3. And then when x equal to 0, y is equal to 3. So x 0, x 0, okay, so x 0, y is equal to 3. Okay, so put here 3. Okay, so graph ni macam mana? Ni senyum lah, because sebab depan ni positif. Okay, so depan tu positif dia senyum. So graf dia macam ni. Okay, ada solid line lah sebab dia equal sign. Okay, so kita kena check lah bawah ni macam mana. Okay, so siapa yang malas nak kira, pergilah check dekat Desmos. Okay, so y is equal to in bracket x minus 2 square and then minus by berapa tadi tu? Okay, so minus by 1. Okay, so minus by 1. Okay, so this is the graph. Okay, so tadi kita dapat 1, 1 dan 3. So below this one is negative 1. Okay, so 2, negative 1. Okay, so here is negative 1. Okay, so tak seimbang kan? Okay, so saya try buat semula. Okay, so negative 1 is here. Yeah. So dia dekat tengah-tengah sini. Okay. And then second one is, it is a straight line. So when y 0, x is 1. So y 0, x is 1 here. And then when x 0, y is negative 1. 0, negative 1. So here. So the straight line like this. Okay. And it is a dotted line because there is no equal sign. So dotted line. Okay, and then second graph, straight line. So when y0 x is 3, y0 x is 3, and then when x0 y is 6. Okay, so when x0 y is 6, so dia dekat atas. Okay, so put here 6. Okay, okay, and then find the shaded region. Okay, so for the first one, y greater than quadratic graph. So quadratic graph greater than dia sebelah atas. So graf yang melengkung ni kita tengok yang sebelah atas, okay? Then y less than x minus 1. So x minus 1, this one, the dotted line. Okay, so tadi sebelah atas dan sekarang yang dotted line ni di sebelah bawah. Okay, so sebelah atas dan sebelah bawah dotted line ni. Okay, so sekarang kita dah nampak yang ni je kan? So kita nampak region dia yang ni. Okay, so saya clearkan dulu. Okay, so and then after that, okay, so after that, last one, which is y less than 6 minus 2x. So for this line, okay, so tadi kita nampak sebelah sini, sekarang less than, so less than below. Okay, so below this line. So therefore the shaded region is here. Okay, so kalau siapa yang payah sangat nak lukis graf tu, pergilah lukis dekat Desmos tu. Okay, so lukis dekat Desmos and then print screen. Okay, so lukis, print screen. Dah print screen, paste dekat Word, lepas tu korang lorek je, okay? So dapatlah nanti jawapan dia. Okay, tapi siapa yang mahir melukis graf ni, so dia akan rasa lukis pakai tangan lagi cepat lah daripada nak guna Desmos. Okay, so another question. Okay, so next question. So this one, for this question we will continue on the next class lah, okay? So this one ini berkaitan dengan circle lagi. So soalan pun dia boleh gabungkan question tu dengan circle, parabola. So nanti kita tengok pada soalan pada kelas seterusnya. Okay, so for today that's all lah. Okay. So tolong fahamkan dulu. Sebab agak, jadi this one agak senang lah, cuma susahnya nak lukis graf tu macam mana. Okay? So try main-main dengan Desmos tu, try guna Desmos. Okay. So kalau nak mahir pun nak try buat example-example yang saya beri ni. Question this one, example this one. Okay, so example this one. Okay, so try buat. Okay, so mahirkan guna Desmos tu, fahamkan macam mana lukis graf. Okay, so that's all for today. See you later on next class. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.